why the hell have we come to this game? Politics. Politics, politics, politics. Guten Morgen. So we're not in Czech today, we're actually in the neighboring country, and we are in Germany for what is my 4-year anniversary with my girlfriend. And I don't think there's anything more romantic than watching a Derby Day football game in the lower leagues of German division. So we're marching sort of with the fans, but behind them on the way to the stadium. And okay, so you might be wondering, why the hell have we come to this game? Politics, 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 and that's why. So in order to understand this game, we need to understand sort of the more macro political background of Eastern Germany. Which, so as we probably know, Germany was split into two countries between 1949 to 1990, East Germany and West Germany. East Germany was socialist, communist, and the West was more democratic like we know it today. Now Babelsberg, like their opponents, Chemnitz, they were both in the DDR Oberliga, which was the East German Football League, which lasted from, I think it was 1947 to 1991. Now in that time, all these teams were socialist. However, due to the dissolution of the Soviet Union, when both Germanys reunited to become one, East Germany between 1990 and sort of like today, it suffered really from deindustrialization, which basically meant the economy of a lot of these Eastern German states was quite shit. So basically it was like poor economy, homogeneous population, and just sort of like hopelessness. It became like a breeding ground for like far right groups. Yeah, but things don't change, they stay the same. German of Cuban descent, Daniel Hillig, is found stabbed to death in Chemnitz by a Syrian refugee. Well, upon hearing this news, Chemnitz FC ultras group form a new group called Chaotic Chemnitz. Within the second day of forming this group, over 6,000 people turn up in the center of Chemnitz and begin to march across the city and begin to attack and destroy anything that sort of resembles immigrants or refugees from Syria. They start to attack people, you know, all this stuff. And it's far-right ideology, which later on it sort of ends up being like a new branch of the former Hunara group formed by Thomas Haller. And what is Hunara? So Hunara stands for Hooligans, Nazis, Racist. It was an actual group in the 90s by sort of a right-wing prominent figure in Chemnitz called Thomas Haller. Thomas Haller, he died in 2019 of cancer. He passed away of cancer. Upon his death, the club Chemnitz, they held a 1-minute silence, and the ultra group, which is like sort of neo-Nazis, they sort of again held a 1-minute silence. And however, the controversy was when former German striker Daniel Fran scored a goal, he took off his t-shirt and it said support your local hooligans after they had just done the minute silence. So he was labeled and received a lot of backlash for his right-wing ideology from the club. Eventually, his contract was terminated later, several months later, in August 2019, because of his links to this right-wing ideology. And where did he end up? In Babelsberg. So while these sort of former Eastern Bloc teams are now like run by right-wing fan bases, Babelsberg are really far-left fan base, and this is exactly why we come to see them. So for example, the stadium is called Karl Lipschnat Stadium, which I believe I pronounced it right, he was one of the founders of the German Communist Party in 1919. A stadium, it has like a flag of the LGBT like flag with the Babelsberg album on it, and they sell like vegan food, they have like LGBT fan groups, you know what I mean? It's quite forward thinking. How would you rate the stadium?
It's nicer than Bohemians.
Okay, she prefers than Bohemians, but I like it. It's got like an English style vibe, like English non-league style vibe, but it's like a mix of like English non-league style with like mixed like the 70s. So like there's only like one section which is like seated, and then the rest is all like standard rear. It's quite cool. I like it.
Very nice.
I'm gonna give it a 6, a solid 6.
6 what?
I don't know, it's cool, it's like you're going back in time. And the music as well is like very ska reggae. Down to 10 men. Yeah. full-time score, 2-0 to Chemnitz. And Babelsberg, to be honest, they didn't really show up today. Chemnitz were down to 10 men. Babelsberg had the whole of the second half to come back, and it just wasn't working. So, similar to global politics today, the right have taken the lead and the right won. So, yeah. Did you enjoy it, Natalie?
Yes, I did. It was good.
Yeah.
I had some sausage and fries.
She had some sausages and fries. Lovely. Sausage and chips.
And chips.
Yeah. And the best bit of the game was the pyro at the beginning, because they set it off to madness one step beyond.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So I guess that's it for the live football now from me until probably the end of January, when the World Cup and the winter break finish, and then we can resume going to live football games. Yeah. So that means in the next 3 months, my girlfriend has my undivided attention, and I think that was a very nice way to spend our fourth year anniversary.
Uh-huh. Maybe so romantic.
Very romantic. Maybe for our fifth year anniversary, we can do something special. Like Boca Juniors or something, no? We can have a gear, maybe. Something beautiful.
Or Indonesia.
Or Indonesia with Jackmania. Let's see what our fifth year anniversary brings us, which stadium it takes us to. Hope you've enjoyed, and see you guys soon.